can't get through.
Why not?
Go to the gate.
She can't.
Why?
She's only done one test.
Just one.
She's only...
Valravn, ancestor of the seers and master of ravens. He hunts his prey with his powers of illusion and feasts on their remains. Follow the path to Valravn and defeat him in battle to earn his mark. The gate to Helheim cannot be opened without it. Ymir was a frost giant, a being of darkness, and all his sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice, Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son, Bor, took a fair giant to be his wife, and they had three sons. Odin was the eldest, and the Northmen hold him to be the foremost of the gods, the All-Father. Illusion hides the path to Valravn. Don't trust your eyes. Find another way to see the truth.
What's that? It's a wall. It's a door. No, it's not. Push it.
Funny. We all want to see behind the veil, don't we? Once we do, we mostly just close our eyes again and pretend what we saw was never really there. Her eyes. Because once you gaze into the relentless darkness, all that lurks within it can see you too.
Valravn's power of illusion comes from ravens, allowing the ravens to break his magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Druth.
Look how much it's changed. It's all
with the mark of Valravn.
Another gate.
Another gate. You know what to do. Stay back. You have to open it. It's not safe. Don't listen to them. Listen. Don't.
To break the seal, align the ravens with the mark of Valravn.
Focus.
into the wilds of her native land, living off berries, roots, and rabbits. It's not uncommon, you see. You call such a person a gelt. Some, like Truth, become gelt in search of pelts. Others, like Senua, to purge a curse. Those who make it back are forever changed.
She can get up now.
What's happening?
She can get up now.
How can she get up?
Must be magic.
Dark magic.
A trick.
Val Raven.
Tricking her.
Val Raven.
How can she get up?
Bait.
It's him.
Dark magic draws her closer.
It's not him.
He's helping her.
It's not him.
It's a trick.
She's doing it on her own.
He's not tricking her.
It's magic.
It's an illusion.
She can't go in there.
Behind
that? Val Raven, he's there.
She can't go in. She can't go in.
Just find another route.
Truth says there's always another route.
Find a way somewhere. Go round somewhere.
Find your own path.
There's a different way.
Ah!
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of man was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as walls. The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home, loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return. Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything, turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.
This reminds her of somewhere. The forest.
Where? Which forest?
The forest in the wilds.
The wilds.
She left Ymir.
She went to the wilds a long time ago.
Why did she go to the wilds?
She wanted to fight her own darkness. She thought she could beat her own...
Did she beat her darkness?
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druth. Druth helped her.
If it wasn't for Druth, she'd be dead.
She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillian.
She came to beat her own darkness and marry Dillian.
But it didn't work.
She thought her curse would affect him.
She thought her curse would spread to him.
She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too.
She nearly died.
She thought the curse made her tainted.
Druth helped her.
Open it.
She has to.
Not from this.
Northmen say you must sacrifice in order to receive. They tell how the runes were revealed to Odin only in sacrifice. He hung himself from the world tree, and he stabbed himself with a spear, and he dedicated a sacrifice to himself. For 9 nights he hung on the tree without food or drink, and at last he saw the runes below him. He gave a cry and gathered them in his mind and learned them. Then he fell from the tree.
The ravens.
The ravens.
They've gone.
They've gone.
No.
Half of them have gone.
They've gone.
Some are still there.
But where?
Some are still there.
And Val why? Ravens helping?
Why is no. He's not helping.
It's a trick.
Quiet. Try.
Out in the wild. Or cold winter woods.
Where have they gone?
She no longer felt fit for this world. She almost gave in to the dark. She remembered Dillian's words. She remembered her promise. She resolved to fight on and kill that which had become a part of her.
Yeah.
of ravens.
They were gone.
No.
There's three.
Where have they gone? She did it, but what does that mean?
Looking back, I was so naive to think she could banish it on her own. The further she saw into the darkness, the more she struggled to see anything at all. And the glow. The smallest hints of shape, sound, or thought grow in strength until they consumed her whole. Before she knew it, the darkness had her in its claws. There is no such thing as victory when it comes to the darkness. It's like it doesn't want to kill her. Yet, it will gnaw at her, biding its time. Only when she is at her weakest will it strike to kill. Will she find Dillion before her time comes?